Good morning, my friends. Welcome back to the Two Ponies channel with Dana and Sleepyhead. Sleepyhead! Okay, so another IBO story this morning. This one has a no in it, and this one has someone not going platinum. So it's the real deal, you guys. I mix in different IBOs into one not kind of a non-fictional fictional story. Just remember that. Names have been changed, all of that kind of stuff. But this story is about Carol. She is a single mom of two preteens, and she's worked at the same company for many, many years. She's a very steady individual. Now, she bought the water treatment, the eSpring water treatment from me, and she was so impressed with it. Now, she's the type who does a lot of research, and she did a ton of research for like 3 months before she finally, you know, because we know each other, she's like, well, I know that, you know, she, let me try this again, words are hard. So she on her own decided she wanted a water treatment system, and she researched a ton of different water treatment systems, and she came up with the eSpring as being the best, and she knows that it's proprietary, pressed charcoal filter system that Amway sells. So she contacted me because she knows I'm an Amway IBO, and she bought one from me. And she loved it. She loved it so much. And then she was talking to me. She had noticed that we have some high-end cookware. And here's, you know, what prompted her. Her and I got to talking about, you know, plastic and how you never microwave anything in plastic. You don't put hot food on anything that's plastic. Because you know the whole, what is it? There's a chemical that they talk about that leaches into your water bottle if your water bottle gets warm. Well, come to find out, that is not the only chemical that leaches into your food. So even though they take that chemical out of our water bottles, there are all kinds of other product, you know, other chemicals that are leaching into our food when you know, heat touches plastic. So anyway, not to get, you know, too technical on that, it was something she was very concerned about. So she started looking up some, you know, cookware, and noticed that we have the iCookware. That hurts. Stop that. And he reached over and scratched me. Not gonna happen again. Yeah, so anyway, she looked up the iCookware, you know, and she was very impressed with it. It wasn't, you know, the most expensive kind out there. It was more affordable, but she felt, you know, comfortable health-wise, and started talking to me about that. And she was also talking about the air treatment system. So anyway, she's like, well, wouldn't it, you know, be better if I signed up so I could get a discount? And we had that conversation. I'm like, okay, well, you know, I don't sign up anybody without fully explaining to them, you know, what you're looking at. This is the cost. You know, you could sign up for whatever the sign up fee was back in the day. It was like 40 some dollars, I think. And here's, you know, how much, here's my cost. I just flat out told her, here's my cost. Here's how the business works, blah, blah, blah. But we're more interested in you being, you know, able to buy these high-end items at a discount. Here's, you know, the difference between retail and IBO cost. It's not huge. So, you know, but she was still interested in doing that because it's still offset enough that she would actually get it cheaper if she signed up as an IBO. And quite honestly, we had this conversation for probably 6 months. And I think, you know, it I think it concerned her that, you know, she was going to, you know, people, about what other people were going to think. So she ultimately said no to signing up. And I feel, and do I feel like that was a waste of time? Absolutely not. I was able to give her the information that she wanted so that she could make an informed decision about, I'm cooking my breakfast, about, you know, something along these lines. You know, this is a direct sales company, network marketing, multi-level marketing, whatever. And I felt good that I gave her all the information she needed to make an informed decision. Did I hear something speak to me? Maybe not. I'm hearing things. I did hit my head yesterday. Anyway, she made an informed decision. However, she ended up buying the cookware. I think she went another route. It's been a while. She went another route for the air treatment system, but she was on the fence with that for a long time. And ultimately, it was a matter of cost, I think. I don't remember exactly why, but she definitely got into the cookware, and she became a steady customer of mine for, like, the SA8, the laundry detergent. She's like, that stuff lasts forever. Same with the LOC. A lot of the Core Line home products, she became one of my regular customers. So here's what happened. Her kids grew up using these products. And, you know, mom always had good things to say about it. So her daughter, Jeannie, ended up, when she turned 18, she came to me and talked. She says, tell me about, you know, some of these other products. And, you know, she had questions about some of these other products. I gave her samples, and she was very interested in becoming an IBO. I said, let's talk to your mom about that, because your mom considered it, you know, several years ago, and ultimately she got enough information, she had decided to say no. I realize you're an adult, you are grown up, you are, you know, capable of making your own decisions, but I think your relationship with your mother and my relationship with your friend, with my friend, is more important than anything else. So I went over there and talked to her about it. She's like, oh no, she was totally cool with it. You know, she just wanted her daughter to be sure to continue to go to college, to continue to get a career. She was just concerned. She didn't want her to get all hyped up and try to make this her big, I'm going to get rich quick kind of thing, you know, do that whole network marketing thing. I said, you know me, I'm not about, you know, pushing people to do that like we did in the day. And she's like, I'm absolutely fine with it. I'm okay. Be sure to come to me if something's going on that makes you uncomfortable. Absolutely. And I signed up her daughter, and Jeannie, she's been in for about 10 years now. She is so into all the products. It is a part-time business, something she does on the side for additional income. She has not gone platinum. She is just enjoying the little extra income. So, you know, there have been one or two times where she's like, I need a little, you know, something for a little bit extra income in the next couple of months. So she kind of, you know, pushed it to get a little bit more, you know, retail sales for like 3 months, 3-4 months, so that she could pay for something that she needed to pay for. And that has worked really well for her. I do believe at some point she's going to go platinum. But in the meantime, she's just having a good time with it. And she has been very, she's been very teachable, especially when it comes to not getting pushy and weird, you know, with your friends and family, right? So we are all about not getting pushy and weird with your friends and family, because they are ultimately more important than any side income, any side hustle, any side business. They are more important. And you know what, truly, if you do that kind of stuff, it gives me a bad reputation. You know, yeah, I have other motivations for not being like that. It's because, you know, first of all, the company as a whole doesn't want us to be like that because it gives them a bad reputation. And I don't want people, you know, turning away, running and screaming when they find out I'm an alley distributor. And honestly, anymore, that doesn't. I seldom run into that because things have changed over the last 15 years. Maybe not quite that long, because Amway's put a stop to all of that. I shouldn't say they put a stop to all of that. There are people out there who do get excited and get a little weird and pushy, but let's not do that. I mean, yeah, it's a great opportunity if you want to go for it, but don't do it in a weird, pushy way. Okay? Okay, I love you guys. Bye.